I'm Allison and I make stuff, and today I'm going to be talking you through my February makes. At the end of my January makes video, I waxed poetic about all the inspiration I had for sewing this month, and I didn't end up actually doing that much sewing, crafting, soaping, any of that in February. I had so many social, I wouldn't say obligations because I was really excited for them, but like social events happening, and I would consider myself an introverted extrovert. So like, I love being around people, but every once in a while I need to recharge by just like chilling out at home and playing video games or like watching TV. And that definitely played into a lot of why I didn't do a lot of sewing. Cause sometimes sewing is what I do to recharge. And sometimes what I do to recharge is just be super duper lazy. So this month it was more about being super duper lazy because I was spending so much of my energy putting that into relationships and friendships. And you know, zero regrets on that front. But you know, I didn't end up doing that much sewing. Most of the sewing I did was at the very beginning of the month. I decided to kind of go through my little sewing cabinet right behind me and do a little bit of organization and found a ton of unfinished objects stuffed in the bottom drawer that I had forgotten about. One of them, I'm very happy I finished because I wear all the time now. So I took those out, finished them. I have a bunch of other knit fabric that I wanted to prepare to sew for the month. Into dresses with my knit pattern, which I drafted myself, which keeping this nice little knit dress in a little envelope. And so I have in front of me probably four new unfinished objects that I started this month that I'm hoping I'll be able to finish next month. If not, it's a great thing to have on hand when I just like need to do some mindless sewing and it's just, you know, finishing necklines or hemming or what have you. So I'm fine with the amount of new unfinished objects. It's kind of funny because I took two unfinished objects, finished them. Now I have like four, so that's doubled. And I made one dress from start to finish because I already bought some new fabric, which I said was one of my goals to not do. But I've been running out of knit fabric to work with, and honestly, that's just something I'm just really into right now, is working with knits. So I bought some fabric that I knew I would get a lot of use out of. Well, I'll show you my makes, but it's a stretch velvet, and that's a lot of what I wear day to day. My kind of like uniform, if you will, is a stretch velvet dress with cardigans and knee socks and kind of like that, almost like a 60s kind of schoolgirl vibe, which I kind of dig. I also don't have that many random makes this month because I didn't do a lot of crafting. I haven't really made any soap this month, though I did buy some oils so I can make some soap, hopefully maybe today or tomorrow. So I'm recording this on the weekend. Yeah, so I have a couple random makes. One of them I might have made last month. It's unclear. I have bad memory. I rewatched my video from last month and I didn't mention it, so I'm just gonna include it this month. Yeah, so enough with the rambling. Let's get into the makes. So unfinished object, UFO. Oh, I forgot to mention, in honor of all my UFOs I've been finishing, I brought out the tea with my X-Files mug. I'm really, really into X-Files. I'm watching it right now with my husband. We're on of the old series, season 7 right now, which is taken us years to get to. But then, you know, it was on for several years, so I don't feel bad about that cadence. But yeah, for all my UFOs, I have my UFO mug. And some really delicious apple black tea. Oh my gosh. Anyways, back to sewing. So this is the first unfinished object I finished this month, which is this blue knit stretch velvet dress. It uses my knit pattern, which I drafted to be kind of more A-line, but I keep on buying not enough yardage or too much yardage when I buy things to make dresses to wear to work. So I had to make it thinner so I could make it long enough to be work appropriate. So I did that. So it's this nice kind of, you know, shift style, beautiful dark blue. I don't know if it's coming across on camera how beautiful this is. Maybe I can get some sunlight on it. There we go. This absolutely gorgeous blue stretch velvet fabric that I've just added to my collection. I get to wear it all the time and, you know, super comfy, stretchy. So I really like this make. It's a nice, wearable, everyday kind of dress for me because I'm a weirdo who wears stretch velvet every day. But yeah, it's absolutely beautiful and I'm very happy to add this to my collection. If you watched my makes video last month, you saw the purple dress I made to wear to a work party I went to at the beginning of February, which is, I guess now it's March, so last month. And I was really on that bandwagon of making like kind of more skater dresses, I guess, style. So like a bodice and then a separate skirt. So this dress, which is a little caught in itself, is, oh gosh, you can see in the camera there's like cat hair and gross stuff on it. My cat likes to sit on my makes. Ew. Anyways, here's this gross dress I need to wash that is a tank top top and a half circle skirt bottom. So it's nice and kind of swooshy to wear, super comfy. This was something I had made at the beginning of January, I think, when I was making that purple dress, just because I really liked how the purple dress fit. Maybe it was the end of January. Anyways, sometime in January, I made the majority of this, and I just finished the neckline, armholes, and hem in February, and yeah, I like it. It's nice, once again, like, just a dress I could throw on, wear to work. It's comfortable. It's a lovely color, kind of rust. And needs to go in the laundry bin. So my last sewing make of the month was the only one that I had made from start to finish, which is this floral kind of velour stretch velvety dress. This is the fabric that I had bought. I also bought another stretch velvet, which I'm hoping to, or another floral stretch velvet that I'm hoping to make a dress out of this month, just because I like how they look and I like how comfortable they are, and I love having a little bit more print in my closet. I wear a lot of just solid color dresses, solid color cardigans, maybe a pattern cardigan, but like for the most part I wear a lot of like really basics and solids, and so I thought it'd be fun for spring to add a little kind of 90s floral into my life. Yeah, so again, I ended up making this a lot less A-line and a lot more kind of shift dressy because I didn't have the length of fabric that I needed to make them more A-line. Note to self in the future, get 2.5 yards instead of 2. So yeah, this is make number 3 and my last sewing make of the month. I will give you a preview of my unfinished objects that I'm hopefully going to finish next month, but I won't show you too much of them because I'm hoping I'll show you them eventually when I actually finish them. Here is a very messy quick preview of what I've started and not finished in the month of February. Once again, a lot of this was started way at the beginning of the month. I know a couple of these are actually kind of old though. Maybe, I think this one I started in like December, so this one might be pretty old. But they're dresses to wear to work and, you know, nice jerseys, so hopefully I'll get those finished up because I could use some more dresses. Some of my older handmade dresses are starting to get a little dingy and might need to be replaced. On to my more random makes. These involve fabric but not necessarily that much sewing, so I'll include them kind of in my random section. But I've made some wrist pin holder things. I really like having pin cushions everywhere because, especially, well, I wish this one was magnetic, it's not, but I like having magnetic pin cushions everywhere. But I find like if I'm in like maybe the dining room using the big floor to map out a project, it's nice to have something on my wrist so I make sure that I'm not getting pins everywhere where they're not supposed to be. So I made a couple prototypes. This was the first one I made. It is clearly not poofy enough really for my liking. And then I made these two. I don't remember which order, but this is using some really pretty red fabric that's actually Rifle Paper Company fabric. And it happened to match some elastic that I already had on hand. I made this with some wooden discs as kind of the base. I'm thinking about making a tutorial for making this. You can find tutorials for making wrist pin cushions of various styles all over YouTube, but I think my version is unique, maybe. So this is really cute. This one I probably won't use. I did think it was great that this fabric I'd used matched the elastic basically perfectly. And then this is made out of some fabric scraps that a friend of mine gave me. This really pretty blue and white floral, and I had some white elastic. So these are really cool. Nice to have a bunch of them sitting around. So yeah, that's random make number one. And my last random make is quite random. I enjoy doing resin crafting using resin. I've showed you last month the pattern mates that I had made out of resin, and I've been doing some little resin crafts. You can buy these metal bezels and fill them, the cavities individually. Oh, that's not focusing. Individually with resin. So I've been doing that. So it's a little crown and a diamond. I'll show a picture of them because it's gonna be really hard to get my camera to focus. But they're cute little, these kind of look like little wands almost, and they have holes in the top so you can turn them into keychains. I don't know what I'm gonna do with them, but this is kind of one of those, you know, it's an afternoon, I need to recharge, what can I do in 20 minutes kind of situations. These are made with UV resin, which means they cure under a UV light. And you can find a lot of videos on YouTube about casting or making crafts with UV resin. And you can find a lot of videos about using these open bezels. Yeah, it's a nice afternoon project, super simple. And because they're UV resin, they don't take a long time to cure like regular, epoxy resin does. So it's like a fun afternoon project. So that was just kind of like a random thing I picked up to do one afternoon. So it's a pretty simple month this month. Couple makes, couple started projects, but a whole lot of friendship and a lot of fun events I've gone to. So all in all, really happy with how February turned out. So I'm really happy to see what March brings me, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.